you are, what you do, the way you think. It's all nothing but a story. How you share information is also in the form of a story. You know? And when you're telling the story or even listening to the story, here comes the listening part. Pay attention to the person's story, whether the exposition has ended. Something happened. Is he spending too much time? Then you stop him. You say, okay, you know, I understood. Now what is the next point? What happened? And that's how you control that. So you control the three boxes of the storytelling of the person who is telling the story. But this is the first step to experience that, not just physically having a stage, and there's no stage here as well, right? Even when you're sitting with somebody on one-on-one, it is a little, there is a demarcation between a storyteller and the listener. There is that little stage, the conceptual stage you are at.
Data storytelling. How do you use tremendous amount of data when you have to talk to people and put that into a story so that they have a higher level of retention of that data? You know, and that's very effective. There's a small example I can give you of that. Okay. Long time back, in a small village, there was a 85-year-old lady, okay, who was married to a 27-year-old boy. 85-year-old lady, married to a 27-year-old boy. Okay. One day, they both decided to go on a honeymoon. They had a red bus, okay, which had a pink number plate. Okay. And the number on the number plate was 887. 85-year-old lady, 27-year-old husband, going on 887 number bus. The 887 number is not relevant, but they get it. And inside that bus, they have 336 people. What is the number?
87,
336,
887,
887, 887,
87-year-old guy,
85-year-old.
387, 886. It's my WhatsApp number, please give me feedback. The story of Ek Tha Raja, Ek Thi Rani, Dono Mahe Khatanda, is a structure. Ek Tha Raja, he died. Because of his death, Rani went into pain and she died. It's the plot. There are basically seven plots in the world. Every story that you have ever heard fits either of these plots. Okay. Seven basic plots is another workshop that we do, but for the sake of this particular workshop, I'm gonna just give you a quick review of that. These are the seven plots, okay, that he came out with. First is the overcoming the monster. Most of the mythological stories that you hear, where a hero has to go and kill a monster, is a overcoming the monster plot. How does this work? The plot, okay? Mm-hmm. That's why this is the most powerful plot. You sit with your team and tell them the rebirth story. It will be most powerful than anyone. As individual goes through a death of ego, the business can go through a rebirth as well. Like brands go through rebirth and all that, right? Mm-hmm. If you look at, like, for example, Pepsi went through a great rebirth after a certain point, and Apple is a great example of rebirth. This company started as a computer company, written the world's best phone company. And they didn't have one rebirth, they had multiple rebirths. Which is Voyage, Quest, and Rebirth is making the right choices based on the right wisdom, going up and killing the monster. In tragedy, the hero begins to fall for temptations and starts to make wrong choices. And at some point, he has come to a point when his inner self has completely been killed. There's no rebirth. Light has become dark. Scarface, Agnipath, Devdas are examples of these movies.
So is a complete thing and plot is one part of it?
The skeleton, the structure.
Yeah.
So coming back to this, right? So storytelling, rising action, you go on a show and tell part, put it here, in this chunk, okay? You don't need to spend too much of show and tell here or at the back. Put it in the center. Cliffhanger. Cliffhanger needs to be put here. Just before the climax. Now, in the first story when I told you about dopamine, I did not resolve your story. I kept it hanging there.
Okay.
I wanted to just demonstrate something. But if you keep the story hanging, this gap remains there. Something inside has to end. There's no ending. The story has to end. It has to conclude something. So the climax has to resolve. The tension that you built has to be resolved by the end of it. So the resolution is where you put your message. It's where you put your message. It's where you let the other person know why he heard your story in the first place. Why he has to invest his time, because finally there's some hormone that is released.
I really appreciate that you guys hosted this session for us. What stayed with me particularly is the interlinkage of the hormones and storytelling. That was an interesting interlinkage, which I've never seen before.
So I really enjoyed the workshop. So we do it intuitively, and some people have it, some people don't have it, but what's interesting is that there is a science behind it, and I think it's always interesting to know the science so that you can make it much better.
Wonderful experience. So storytelling is a part of our life, everyday life, and I was here to learn how to involve in all the spheres of life, and it was a wonderful experience. I learned from starting creating the story to the end of it, and at the end creating my own story. So it was an empowering workshop.